Hey everyone, and welcome back to episode 374 of Fallout 4. Last episode, glory to concrete walls. Glory to concrete walls! So they, like, finally, I figured out that I can put them underground. It's kind of amazing. I don't really have that many resources when it comes to making them, but I want to make as many as I can. We did come back from Finch Farm to Grey Garden to pick up some things, and we talked to the people at Oberland Station, and funny story, I completed this quest, like, forever ago. I don't even remember doing it. I'm not sure if it was the ghouls at the Beantown Brewery or what, but they were happy just, like, with me talking to them. Did I scare somebody? Oh, I definitely, like, scared the shit out of you. they were happy with just, like, me going to be, just talking to them. We're good. We did get some people here because we put down the recruitment bacon and things like that. We have four people. We don't have enough beds. I guess it wouldn't be a bad idea just temporarily. So, can I put beds in here? It looks like I might be able to. Maybe. There's not a lot of space. You know what? Let's scrap some of this stuff. Can I get rid of this one? Yes, I can. Goodbye, bed. Scrap all of this crap. But yeah, we started recruiting people here. I'm just going to move some beds around. Of course, happiness is going down. They don't like that. But my plan is to, like, try to wall off as much of this as I can. I just want to see what it's going to look like. I mean, I've always wanted to have a settlement completely walled off because I was always annoyed by, like, settlement attacks, and I always wanted to kind of throttle, like, where enemies can come from, and I might not be able to squeeze a bed here. This was just for science sake. I always wanted to be able to throttle where enemies could come from, like, funnel them in, and there is, like a door thingy that you... Ooh, was that... was there a spot? There's, like, a door thingy you can make with the concrete walls that I'm assuming I can mess around with, like... Ooh, wow, seriously? Like, pixel-perfect placement, but it worked. So, I'm gonna mess around with that a little to see how that goes, and... Yeah, fingers crossed that that works out well. Rotating that bed did literally nothing, but there's six beds. It's more than they needed, so they should be a little less inclined to be butthurt. Now, concrete walls are using concrete, obviously. It's 8 per wall, which is a surprising amount. And I don't have a lot of it because it's not something we find in the Commonwealth a lot. I might end up going to a vendor and seeing if they're selling it. Can I get rid of you? I cannot. You can buy shipments of concrete, and I might do that. Now, if I were to snap this, am I going to be allowed to go this way or no? Probably not a good idea to do this because, again, I've mentioned this before. This is kind of like on a slight diagonal where I think it's going to give out, and plus that wood's in the way. Yeah, so you know what? We will not store you. I want to just, I guess, continue this way, unfortunately. So it means I lose a little bit of the space to work with, but I don't think it's that big of a deal. Come on, snap. Ah, the fact that they just go underground is, like, so boner-inducing. I'm gonna put as much of this down as I can, and you know what? Here's another problem. I can do this, and it'll also snap to, like, different points. I love the different anchor points. More walls need this. But then there's, like, that goofy overlay. And if I... Okay, tell you what. Because of the way that this is curved, right here is where this wall ends. That wouldn't be too bad, but I get some extra building space if I sucked it up and kind of, like, snapped the wall here somewhere. Can I snap you, like, right here? Then that would also kind of throw off the design. You know what? I think it's a good idea to not do it that way, but keep it going kind of like this. That way I don't have any, like, inconsistencies of the wall. It's all the same pattern. Can you snap, please? There you go. I'm really hoping that this will work. Or... Come on, go down, go down. Come on, I can't with my camera. I can't make... There you go. Okay, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to fix this. Nope. Can I snap it? Yes. And then can I snap? Oh! Oh, we had it. Oh, yes! Yes, I don't want any of those, like, empty, like, those blind spots where, like a, for example, a ghoul could crawl through or something silly like that. I want, like, this to be impenetrable. I want this to be a real little fort, and yes, I know there's an entire settlement that we can use that's, like, literally a fort, but I figured I could mess with Oberland Station because it's not that big of a settlement to begin with, and I just kind of wanted to have fun here. Now this, I don't feel as if there's any way I'm going to be able to get walls underneath. I don't think it's going to happen. It's a very tiny piece. Can you snap? It's a very tiny piece Come on, come on, come on! Sometimes they get really janky. Okay. Now if I do this, can I snap right here? Yeah. Maybe. Oh. 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 At one point there was a snap. Oh. That's not the snap we're looking for. I hate. It's got a goddamn mind of its own. Oh. Oh God. Walls are fun, and everything, but. See, I gotta figure a way to plug that. I don't want to let that open. Like, that also could be misconstrued for, like, sticking my penis where, you know, never mind. It could be a thinly veiled dick joke. I want to plug that hole, but I also really want to plug this hole right here. Come on. Oh! I don't want to have to put walls on their side like this. That'd be goofy. Oh, God. I feel like we're getting it, but we're not getting it. Come on! Alright, I'll come back to that. Now, I don't want to add another wall to this because we would be outside the buildable area, and that Brahmin, I think, just spawned there. I'm pretty sure that Brahmin just spawned. Bye, Brahmin! Okay, that was weird. But I'm pretty sure that Brahmin just spawned there. Now, do I want to go inside the wall or outside the wall? Because that might throw off the whole design. I haven't been thinking about that. And what I mean is, like, where did I start? Where did I start? So we're inside the wall here. Then we're inside the wall there. Inside the wall. Okay, inside the wall. Okay, I think we're okay. Let's just continue with the design we have set up. But look at this, like, any settler in here is just immune to, like, any attack. Like, no one's going to be able to walk into the settlement and do anything. They just can't reach it. That's what I wanted. Like, imagine a Deathclaw spawn for our settlement attack. What's the Deathclaw gonna do? Jump over our fence? I'm pretty goddamn sure Deathclaws actually can't do that. I mean, I don't know of any enemy off the top of my head that is capable of climbing. I'm actually drawing a blank. Like, whatchamacallit, a mole rat could. It could just burrow under, I guess, but are we gonna get mole rat attacks? Like, is that even a thing? Can you snap, please? Like, right here? There you go. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this either. There might be a little... Every now and then there's a couple blank spots, but I mean, for the most part, I'm happy. And I could just put something there. Like, I don't think it's going to want to let me. Basically, I can't put the wall any further down. There seems to be some kind of hard block it's hitting. Essentially, what I'm thinking is you can only put a block so far underground. I think that's what's happening. Oh God, the snapping. Who's talking? Something about somebody's daughter is what I just heard. I'm not sure.
I don't know how they carry on after something like that.
Damn vultures. It's better to just let them take what they want.
I'm not sure if they're talking about the Abernathys and that one girl that died. I think that's what they're doing. Okay, thankfully this building did not get in the way. Oh god. Yeah, idiot savant. I don't think that building's gonna get in the way. I think we're okay. Now I'll still have to figure out where the actual, like, door to this place will go. It just means I'll break a block down or something. So snap, snap. I don't expect to have too much trouble putting walls here. And you can see we finally ran out of walls. I ran out of concrete. Oh, no. Maybe. See, I can't put that any further down, so I don't think it's gonna let me snap it. So there's gonna be like that little hole there. Now I could just put like a sandbag or something silly kind of like there. You know, I could block it off, but it sucks I can't put the concrete wall. It's a miracle that I was able to do what I was able to do with the terrain being as uneven as it is. Now imagine if I worked on a settlement that was flat. You have no fucking problems. Okay. What I think I should do. Take my inventory, just store junk. We're all good. I just want to make sure everything in my inventory is out of it because I don't want it on me. I'm going to go to Grey Garden real fast and see if the it's literally just across this thing right here. I want to see if the generic vendor there... Oh, I'm also hungry. I really ought to eat. The generic vendor, I'm banking on them having... Really, that ribeye steak didn't do shit? I am that hungry? Well, ribeye steaks are that inferior to rat scorpion steaks? Whatever. Also, everything just popped in. Fingers crossed that he sells concrete is what I'm getting at. If we find, like, Trash Can Carla, we find a wandering trader. That one vendor dude that we always saw in front of... The Covenant? Yeah, I think that's what it was. I wonder if maybe he sells concrete. I don't know. I need to start looking for shipments of items. And as I understand it, And I don't think it's instantaneous. I could be wrong. But you just put the shipment in your workshop, and then you come back later on, and then you have that much of that resource available to you. And of course, because this is a supply line, we should have it. I am not certain what this person thinks they're doing. There's quite literally a bridge here. Are you going to swim across to Oberland? Are you going to swim to Oberland Station? Is that your intent? Is that your intent? Oh, Provisioner AI is so silly. Okay, so Vendor Dude's not here doing Vendor Dude things. Curie, shh. That guy obviously will not be selling anything. Is this even manned anymore? Did, like, something happen? Yeah, it's definitely manned. Trading Emporium makes the settlement happier. Okay, that's cool. I don't see the dude. And we've actually changed the vendors. Because, like, shenanigans. You know, I don't want this stupid mat here anymore. I don't know. Let me get rid of any rads I may have had. Fusion core is still okay. I just want to check that. It's a bit annoying. And what No, I don't want the stupid wheel thingy to come up. I hate that console crap. I'm kind of, like, curious. Like, let me just assign you. I know she's supposedly, like, a vendor for clothing. Well, I'm just gonna send her to the general store real quick to see what happens. See if I can talk to her.
What have you got to trade today?
Okay, what do you have? Junk. It is junk. Like, that's what we're looking for. Here you go. See? Exactly. Shipment of concrete. That's all I needed. Now, I'm gonna cancel the trade and pull out a shitload of junk to give her in exchange for it. So it's like 400 something caps worth. All this 10 millimeter. Nothing unique. Crappy knuckles. Minigun, that would probably be fine enough, just one minigun. That, and I'll bring some small things to try and even the trade out a little bit, and that should be good enough. Let's see here. Hey, Anne, trade.
What have you got to trade today?
I like how she skips the dialogue. That actually saves a hell of a lot of time. Because the other guy was always, like, talking and things. So, concrete and concrete. All right, and let's go to weapons. Take all the 10 millimeters, trying to even the trade out as much as possible. And then, of course, take any money that she has. Pipe revolver, pistol. We're almost there. Almost there. Okay, so she owes me 5 caps. A bag of cement. There's concrete. Okay, I should be able to give her some knuckles. Sure. If I take this, that means she owes me 2. Is there anything that's worth, like, literally 2? There. She's completely broke. Are you happy, ma'am? You're completely broke. Alright, I am going to store the junk. I think if I go to my junk and I press T, yeah, it'll store those shipments as well. Good to go. Now, ammo. I don't want the 38 on me, obviously. And I don't want any and all extra weapons on me. So that, we just turned all of what she had into, well, usable resources, exchange crap for caps. And now I think I should have, I don't know if it's instantaneous. Again, let me actually look. Structures, concrete, floors, for example. Concrete, I now have that. I now have 314 concrete to work with. So I don't have to, I guess whenever I go to craft, what it's going to do is it's just going to break it down. I think it's actually really hurt. Can I repair it? No. Let's see. Yeah, look, it's got, like, no health. I assume what's going to happen is when I go to make the wall, and I don't have concrete, it's going to take from that shipment and then break it down into pure concrete instead of saying shipment. I might be wrong. I haven't really dabbled too much in shipments. But now we have 300 and something, 311 more concrete to work with in Oberland. And pretty much any generic vendor, I guess, that I talk to, not to mention, like, all the random traders out in the world. Well, most of them have shipments. I don't know about shipments of concrete, but we're pretty likely to just come across a shipment of concrete. So it's a good way for me to just have another thing to spend money on with all the junk that I'm obtaining. So I can just break down all my junk and then exchange it for concrete. Because maybe I make more walls like this in other settlements. I don't know. So far, I'm really liking this idea. I just want to see what all I can do with it. So let's go back to structures, concrete, walls. What is that, like? Like a roof out of concrete? Like, concrete stairs are going to look cool? Miscellaneous. I think that's it's steel, but it's listed under concrete. Actually looks really bad, this railing. Okay. We're here for the walls, though. And let's just finish the connecting walls off, because these are clearly the most important ones. And is this gonna connect perfectly or what? Okay, that didn't snap. Well, it connected perfectly. It didn't snap. That was weird. Hey, happiness is going up in this place because of the fact that I put the beds down. Awesome. So I can't do what I wanted to do here. Like that. From the outside perspective, I can just... Ooh, hold on. Did that just tell me? If not for a split second, that it was okay to put it there? I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy. I think I'm crazy. But like, I could do something like this, and you would never see it from inside the settlement. Like, you'd see like a little like hole kind of in the wall, but I would know no enemy can come through. I just wish it would snap. That's like the one place. You bastard. Well, we'll do that. I think it kind of snapped. No, that's not gonna do what I want to do. Can I snap it to like the boot? There was a snap there, but I don't think it was... Oh, God. It makes me want to just keep trying, but I know it's not going to work. It's all right. We'll lower it down. Like, right... Try to make it look as nice as I can, because it's obviously not snapping. I bet the easiest thing to do would be to come from up top. That way I can get the angle correct. Okay. And then there's... How's that looking? That's looking pretty good, and that, I think, walled all of it off. Come on, Jetpack, do your thing. There's a slight gap there. It looks weird to me, I know. But I could even do... There's a lot that I could do, but for now I'm going to leave that. Let me actually work on like the next layer of walls. That's what I should focus on, I feel. I just want to get the shit walled off at least so that nothing can come through here, and then start worrying about where I'm going to put my turrets. And I will have to like hope to God that we don't have any attacks that spawn within the settlements, because remember, I've seen that with Sanctuary. And that's what I've always been concerned about when it comes to walls. I've always really liked the wall idea for a settlement, but I've hated the fact that I've seen enemies spawn in my settlement. Which I guess I'll just do this, which is a little bit janky. Wish they'd spawn outside then run in every time. Because there's a pile of ghouls in Sanctuary, right by like my workshop and everything. It was the weirdest thing. I don't know if these are snapping correctly. Let's check. Good. The only reason I asked that or say that is because there are multiple snapping points, and who knows if it's going to the right one. From this angle, I can't really tell. Okay. Oh, I fell a whole layer down. I was wondering, like, what the hell happened here? Okay. Come on. Oi! It's so finicky. It might be better to do it from this angle. Oh, yeah. Definitely gonna be better. So I have, like windows and stuff to work with. Like, this is really cool. Like, those are points we can shoot from. Ooh. Oh, I didn't even notice that. A line, that's kind of cool. So you can do, like, rounded edges. That's neat. So I could just, like, round this off if I wanted to. Don't have any need for it. Angled doorway, that's kind of cool. I'm not sure. I know what I could use this for, but that might be the answer to some problems. Maybe. We'll see. I'll mess around with that a little bit here in a bit. I want to get these walls done. There's so much under the concrete tab that I haven't really ever dabbled with. I'm just discovering this now for the first time, so it's amazing. Yeah, it's new and fresh and amazing to me. Man, look at this, like, hole in the wall. Yeah, that's a little disturbing, disheartening. I don't think I'm going to put, like, a roof on this or anything like that. That would just be silly. But I want this place to be super well defended. And that means those stupid sentry bots that come in your base and explode aren't going to be able to come into your base and explode, you know? And blow up your stuff. Destroy your crops. They're just not going to get in the damn settlement. Oh, it's so defended. It's so weird. It's so weird having this walled off. I could even put like a doorway here or something. Maybe. We'll have to see. I could jimmy up a door. Oh, maybe. I could do like a little... These little thin pieces. Oh my god, the ideas right now. The ideas. Hey, idiots. Yeah, you keep doing your thing, buddy. And I realize I shouldn't be in my power armor while I do this, but like... I kind of have a lot of fusion cores. And it's not the most efficient thing, but at this point, I think we're okay. One more here. Yeah, buddy. This is good. I love it. I thoroughly enjoy this. Now this right here, this is a low point. I don't know if I want to stack a third layer of wall on this or not, but let's see what two layers of wall looks like. I have to remember I am contributing to the settlement size quite a bit, putting walls down, so that reduces the amount of stuff that I can put within the settlement. So I mean, there's trade-offs to making these walls. I could always install the mod that lets me just forego all that. But I am finally out of concrete now. Oh my god, it looks so... It looks so dreary. But I figure, like, once I wall up, like, lights and things like that... Well, wire up lights to the walls. And put, like, doors and... I feel like there's some potential for this settlement. So... Maybe I get the basics down for these dudes. And then I get the hell out of here until I can start amassing more concrete. Like, go buy some shipments as I explore. Because right now I'm out of it, and Grey Garden's out of everything too. So unless I guess I could put a vendor down here. That one dude's not doing anything. And see if he just sells concrete. You know what? Let's do it. Let's just put some crappy beds out here. It doesn't matter. You gotta go. I never even made. You were just kind of here. You were a freebie. Can you get away from... There you go. Can you get away from me? I can't place it when you're so close. That was just weird. So, at least they're kind of sort of protected from the elements. There's sort of half of a roof over their heads. They've got nothing to complain about, right? Just putting a couple beds down so the settlement can expand. Alright. Oh, no. I definitely pressed E. Thank you. So, I'm thinking a store, trader, armor, weapons, clinic, clothing. I'm guessing generic trader is what we're going to want for this. So trading emporium. Why don't we give these guys the fancy stuff? You can be a proud owner of a trading emporium too. And it would literally be floating if I put it here. So Hancock, you dingus. Get out. Hancock, you dingus. I think the rads are going in your head. Just running into a damn wall. But let's put a trading emporium like up in the corner. Do you have a job? I don't believe you do. Here you go, man.
Okay.
Yeah, I like your attitude. Good job.
I just want to trade a few things.
I'm sure I have something you need.
Hey, buddy.
Let's see what you have.
Great.
The spotlight look on his face. The inventory bug thingamajig. I'm assuming that means it's past 8 o'clock. Okay. Well, let's get out of our power armor and sleep. And see if this dude has some concrete for us in the morning. Because I want to keep doing this. I want to at least finish something off a little bit. You know, because... It's just not there yet. It's a wall, but I kind of feel weird leaving it off where it is right now. So, yeah. Let's keep going. It's not 8 a.m. yet. Should have slept for longer. We'll go to 8:45. 8:45 should be good. I feel ill, lethargy, yet I feel well-rested. I feel as if this game is yanking my chain. Let's drink, because now we are dehydrated. I'm sorry, not just dehydrated, we are mildly dehydrated. let's get some fluids in us. Still parched. Probably hydrated. Is he at his store? Oh, yes he is. Hey, dude, what you got for me?
Hey there.
Looking to buy?
Oh my god, I'm like...
I'll take a look.
I'm like a kid at a candy store. It's like, hey sir, can I have that lollipop? I'm like looking up at him. That's not weird or anything. Ooh, hold on. Was there a bag of cement? Yep. Concrete. Shipments of concrete, please. Yes. Give me all your concrete shipments. And I don't really have anything to trade this dude. Which kind of blows because now he has an ass load of money. You know what? Let's do this. Is there anything in here to sell? Did I drop anything off worth a damn? No. Let's go back to Grey Garden. And actually, I can check the other vendor there, too, to see if she replenished her stock, which I doubt it, but we can check. So, he's got 400-something caps to blow. I have all that stuff. I might as well go bring crap over here and exchange it. We can slowly work out what's in Grey Garden.
Looks good on you.
Well, thanks, man. There's a lot that's in Grey Garden. We can slowly work on getting rid of what's there. I mean, I guess this isn't slowly. This is actually pretty rapidly. We're really getting rid of a lot of junk doing it this way. I'm liking this. Like, this is cool. It looks like butts from the outside, but like I feel as if when there's lights and everything's lined up and I think it's gonna come together. It's gonna be pretty neat. It's gonna be different. I could put like turrets in the windows and shit. It's a freaking like prison encampment. I know, but they're well defended at least. It looks dreary, but I like it. Anyway, guys, it is time to wrap the episode up here. I am sorry to say episode 374, Fallout 4. More walls. I know walls might not be the most entertaining thing to some people, but I do enjoy my settlement building every now and then, and it's been quite a while since we've really committed. And now that I've discovered these concrete walls, I'm having a lot of fun. But yep, gonna wrap it up here, guys. Episode 374. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.